Learn Excel from Mr. Excel Podcast, episode 1986, Sideways with a Formula. Well, hey, don't forget to subscribe to the playlist. I'll be podcasting the entire book. Welcome back to Mr. Excel Netcast. I'm Bill Jelen. We need to take this data that's going across and make it go down, right? So the fancy word for that in Excel is to transpose. So Control-C there, and then you can either right-click and choose transpose, or paste transpose, or paste special and choose transpose. Any of those will work. So there's the transpose in paste special. Let's right click. This one here is transpose. The problem with that though is that this is a one-time snapshot, right? This took the data as it was, and if these are formulas that are changing, well, now we're out of sync, right? So I did the copy, I did the paste, and now these numbers have changed, but those are not live links, all right? So there's a couple of different ways to do this. And the first one is a bizarre formula. It's a function called transpose. Transpose is one formula that's going to return many answers, 12 columns by 2 rows. So I have to choose 12 rows by 2 columns. All right, you can look up there in the name box to see how many you've chosen. With all of that selected, we're going to do equal transpose and point to the original array. Now here's the most important part. You can't press Enter here. You have to do Control-Shift-Enter. Control-Shift-Enter. This creates an array formula, right? It's one formula returns many results. All right, it works great. A couple of hassles. If you give this to someone who doesn't understand what array formulas are, they might come in here and edit something and, you know to press Control-Shift-Enter. It's kind of a hassle. In fact, you know, one of the things that array formulas are great for, right, because no one understands them. Let me just insert a worksheet here and just say, put instructions here, do not delete any of these rows, right, and then you have stuff here. And of course, if you do this, you know that whoever you give the spreadsheet to is going to delete one of those, all right? So what I do is if I want to protect rows 3 through 12, I just come out here to the right where no one can see out here, select 3 through 12, and build an array formula equal to Control-Shift-Enter, right? And now because that array formula is sitting out there, when someone comes here and tries to delete one of these rows, you can't change part of an array, right? It'll prevent them from deleting it. No one will understand what this means, right? So array formulas are amazing. And, you know, hey, shout out to Mike Girvin and his Control-Shift-Enter book, right, that covers array formulas. If you want to, you know, just be amazing with Excel, read that book. But for this simple little task here, although this works great, you know, there's problems. All right, so let's talk about something, another way to go. The index function. Index says, here's a whole bunch of answers, and I want the comma first answer like that, right? And that gets that 1%. And then if I copy that down and edit the formula, let's put the dollar signs in back up here, C2 to N1, we'll put dollar signs there, I'll press F4. Copy that down, edit the formula, and go to 2. Copy that down, edit the formula, and go to 3. Well, this is really tedious. You know, a beautiful way to get the number 1 to change to 2 is to ask for the row of 1:1. And as I copy that down, it will automatically change to 2:2. So the row function tells us what row something's in. But this is just a great trick to make sure that we expand the range. So over here, instead of asking for hard coding the 1, I can ask for the row of 1:1, like that, right? And this is really good. This works reliably. You don't have to worry about anyone pressing Control Shift Enter. It's a lot of numbers up, you know, up at the top change. Things will change, all right? But you know, still index and row. It's a complicated formula, right? So I don't know. I would probably do this. There is the third method. I've seen Bob Umlis do this, where you just simply build a regular old formula like this, all right? And so now I have a simple array of formulas, and then I use find and replace, Control-H, change the array occurrence of an equal to caret equals. I've seen a lot of different things there, but carets work, replace all. And that takes those formulas, and it makes them not be formulas anymore. Here, let's make it a little bit wider. And now I'm going to copy that, Control-C, and paste special transpose, all right? And so now that brought those formulas down, and it didn't change them as I brought them down. And now Control-H again, and we'll change K caret equals to equals, and then replace all. Right, and now we have true live formulas, just simple little formulas, but I didn't have to build them one at a time. This method, it's like once every 3 months that I come up with some bizarre thing where it's easier just to build the formulas and then, you know, cut them and move them somewhere else. And the caret trick, it's a good trick to have in your arsenal every now and then. Well, hey, as I said, I'm going to be podcasting this whole book. It looks like it's going to take at least the whole month, maybe 6 weeks or so. But you know, save time. You can buy the whole book now. Click that I in the top right-hand corner and go out and check out the book, 40 Excel Tips, plus a lot of other great stuff. All right, recap of this episode, paste special transpose. It's great, but it does a snapshot of the data. If the original data is changing, it's not going to work. The transpose function is great. Works with CTRL+Shift+Enter. We talked about using CTRL+Shift+Enter with equals 2 to prevent people from deleting rows. That's off to the right-hand side. Index function with position, but then you have to change the 1 to a 2 to a 3. Row of 1 colon 1 gives you the number 1, and it will change to 2 automatically. So combine the index and the row. And then the third method, replacing equal with caret equals. Hey, remember the whole book was crowdsourced to people sending their favorite Excel tips. So Excel Ace and Tracia Williams suggested this feature. So thanks to them and thanks to you for stopping by. We'll see you next time for another netcast from Mr. Excel.